I felt the same thing. Listen, it didn't stop there. They asked me, when I opened the door, they asked me, who was that girl came, jumped over the fence and kissed you? So he was from Oxford, he used to study there and came from accent to play the test match. So that English accent was that, well, I don't know, you know, that sort of thing. And those six girls kissed him in front of me. I was just looking at them, just in that. Just imagine. And Abbas came and showed his face to me. All over there was lipstick. I just threw myself inside, you know, I covered myself. Only for 50 he got this, you know, girls kissing. Only for 50. Just next match I got 100 runs. I was also looking for somebody to jump over. But I was not disappointed. There was one person from Madras, Lungi Wala. He held his lungi, came running and garlanded me and kissed me. That is what happened when I was there. So that happens. When you perform well, this happens. Okay?
So those are the fringe benefits of playing cricket. Sir,
but
I also...
Nowadays, let me tell you, nowadays boys are scared, you know. They run away from the girls. There are so many girls are after these boys, you know. In the past, they never used to, particularly their parents, they never used to give their daughter to the cricketers for marriage. But nowadays, the parents are after the cricketers, Baba, marry my daughter and something like that. It is the other way around. Lot of money is there. Lot of things are there. Yes, good. But these cricketers are very honest and nice. And look at, you know, all these players. They are doing very, very well in life. If you make a good career out of cricket, you can be crorepati in no time. Really, I'll tell you. In any sports now, back home, I'm talking about in our country, I mean in India, people in tennis also, they are making good money. Badminton, look at Nehal, badminton, she's crorepati. Tennis players are crorepati. Now hockey players are also getting, lot of even kabaddi players, but they won, the ladies won the World Cup and they got, each girl got 1 crore, just like that, playing, they won the finals. So the sport, you can make career out of the sports, and if you perform well. I think here also, if you do well in sports, you can make career out of it. Of course, it is a challenge, a big, big challenge. I told you earlier, challenge is there not only in sport, but everywhere. So I leave it to you how to take, stand up to those challenges. That is very important.
Being an avid follower of cricket, my question to you is quite technical, which you must have not ever imagined from a girl. So my question is, why don't we give emphasis on pace-friendly tracks in our domestic circuit? In our Ranji pitches, batsmen are quite comfortable where the bowlers struggle, while on the pitches of Australia and England, the batsmen find it quite difficult to cope up with the bounce.
And the Indian players also find it very difficult to perform well on the Australian wickets, because the bounce is more there on the Australian wickets. And they have deliberately prepared those wickets, fast wickets, to suit their bowling attack. Similarly, in India, when the other team comes to play in India, we prepare the turning wicket, slow wickets. That's where we perform better. So the every team, they try to take advantage of the situation. Particularly, they prepare the wickets accordingly to suit their type of bowlers, and that's how they perform well.
Thank you, sir.
This is everywhere you will find, not only in Australia, but in India also, we prepare the slow turning wickets. But our spinners are much, much better than the other spinners. But when we go out, now we will be touring shortly to South Africa. It will be challenge before our youngsters, our these players. It will be big challenge. Last time when we went, we were beaten by them. So let us see, let us hope that our these present lot, they perform well in on the South African tour. Let us hope so.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Sushmita. My question is, whom do you find the most complete cricketer in your time?
You know, it's very difficult for me to answer this question, because if I'll answer that such and such player was a very good cricketer, I will be, you know, hurting the other players also. But let me say, they were very good cricketers also. I am one of those fortunate ones who played in three decades as a player, as an administrator, as a chairman. And when I was playing that time, during our time, that decade, Vijay Hazare was a great batsman, tremendous player, fantastic. You could say that Sachin now is the greatest player. That time in India, Hazare was good. Afterwards, it was Sunil Gavaskar. He performed extremely well. If you see his performances, he broke the Bradman's record, I think, in centuries, you know. And after that, now it's Sachin. So in these three decades, I saw three great batsmen. But I saw three bowlers also. Kapil was also a great bowler. To perform so well on the Indian soil, it's a tremendous performance. Then nowadays, these youngsters, what they are doing are fantastic performances. So to select one person, it becomes very, very difficult. I played against foreign countries also, where Sobers was great, Peter May was great, Sir Frank Worrell was great, Ron Kanai was great. Then there were so many other players whose performances were very good for that particular time. And to select one out of that, it becomes very, very embarrassing for me to do that, because I'll be hurting other sentimentals also. So I don't want to name a particular person for that.
I'm Anukriti from class 9A, and I would like to ask that, looking back at your cricketing career, what do you cherish as your best cricketing moment?
No, I told in my lecture, facing those fast bowlers, the West Indian fast bowlers, that was a tremendous challenge. And then afterwards, touring England. Because what happened, that time the English team was number one in the world. And what happened, they prepared the wickets to suit their bowlers, that is called green top wickets. Green top wickets means they put a lot of grass on the wicket, and then the swing takes a, you know, it swings quite a lot, and particularly their climatical conditions help the fast bowlers. So we are not used to that kind of a situation here in India. Ours is a dry country, and the wickets are slow, and there is hardly any grass on the wicket, so ball doesn't swing that to that extent. So it was a big challenge facing those fast bowlers. Now there, Statham, Truman, Tyson, they were equally fast like these West Indian players, and it was a challenging thing for me also. Not only for me, for others are also. In fact, I'll tell you one story. Before going to England in 1958, we were told to meet Meher Baba and take his blessings. So everybody was asked to sort of go to him, bow down, touch his feet and take the blessing. So he gave blessing to everyone that your performances will be fantastic and blessed us. When we went to England, we were thrashed 5-0, left and right. And each team in England scored more than 350 runs in a day. We were so tired, and no one performed well at all. So don't believe in these kind of blessings and other things. Depend on your talent and performance. And it was so challenging, let me tell you very frankly, that it was difficult to face those fast bowlers on those grounds in English.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. We'll have a last question.
How did your association with cricket influence your personal life?
Well, let me tell you, cricket, this game is such, I used to play other games also, like tennis and badminton also, but why I was attracted towards cricket, because when I was youngsters, I used to go on the ground to play, you know, gilli danda and to fly the kites and other thing. But then what happened, the members, they used to come and they used to say, hey, chokra, chalo, ball feko. So I got attracted towards this. Gradually I started looking at them, started learning. And I told you earlier, at the age of 16 when I was in school, that time I was selected to play for Maharashtra. And I performed well against Bombay. And we won the match because of my performances. That attracted me. That, you know, I was so elated, and everyone started, you know, looking at me as a future cricket player for the country. And I immediately was taken to Pakistan, like Sachin was taken to Pakistan at the age of 16 and a half, and I was the manager on that trip because of the performances. And once you love something, you don't want to give up just like that. And when you work hard to achieve something in life, you don't and start working hard towards it, and you are performing well, naturally you don't feel like living that game. Therefore, Sachin, he also didn't feel like living the, retiring from the game. He still continued to play at the age of 40. I went on to play till the age of 39. So when you love something, you don't want to give up. And when I took the decision, it was 3 o'clock in the morning. I didn't feel like retiring. So if you love something, and if you enjoy it, keep it up. And you must have one thing, children, you must have some hobby in life that will help you quite a lot. Okay?
There are some messages. We will put this on the video, YouTube. But I think there are a lot of messages for us. Especially we are looking forward to graduating in 2-3 years, and there are daily life lessons that Mr. Bode has shared, particularly about concentration, you know, go for your passion, and particularly try to improve the fact that he talked about Tendulkar going and facing the next day and improving on and making sure the mistake doesn't happen again. I think these are all lessons for us on everyday life. And I'm sure you will utilize them to the best of your abilities.
Whatever the games you are playing as a team, please play for the team. Don't play for individual performances. That doesn't help you.
This brings us to the end of another episode of the Leadership Lecture Series. It has been most certainly a memorable experience, and we thank the Venerable Mr. Bode for taking time to address our school and sharing his valuable, and may I say, youthful experiences with us.